President of today's massive militant convention, Sri Thirumavalavan. Talapati, Sri M.K. Stalin. Respected Sri K. Veeramani. Sri Sinathai Chalavan. Sri D. Ravi Kumar, Sri N. Muhammad Yusuf, Kodikunil Suresh, Comrade Muthurasan, Thiru K. N. Nehru, Comrade Sitaram Yechuri, General Secretary CPIM, Professor Kader Mohiuddin, Muttuja Gajan, Neelavanan, Thiruvakka Sarar, ஸ்ரீ கே காமரேட் கே பாலகிருஷ்ணன், ஜவஹருல்லாஜி, கே என் அருள் அண்ட் அதர் லீடர்ஸ் ஆன் த டயாஸ் அண்ட் மை டியர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், ஐ எம் எக்ஸ்ட்ரீம்லி ஹாப்பி டு பார்ட்டிசிபேட் இன் டுடேஸ் ஹியூஜ் கன்வென்ஷன் சேவ் இண்டியா பை விசிகே பார்ட்டி. I congratulate VCK party and our friend Thirumavalavan for taking this initiative at a time when the nation is facing a serious threat from communalists. I support the resolution proposed by Sri Thirumavalavan as the resolution reflects the today's political situation and the remedies. Hindutva forces, Sanatan Samstha and other organizations are out to attack the secularism in this country, democracy, constitution. Sanatan Samstha, he is the most venomous serpent unleashed by Narendra Modi against the intellectuals in this country. Unfortunately, several intellectuals are already been targeted and killed, as has been said in the resolution. Communist Party of India's National Control Commission Secretary, Comrade Govind Pansare, Narendra Dabolkar and rationalist say Professor Kalburgi, journalist Gauri Lankesh, these people are killed and there is a long list including the leaders of the VCK. This should not be tolerated. For the last 4.5 years under the leadership of Narendra Modi, this government systematically destroyed many independent institutions like Reserve Bank of India, Medical Council of India, CBI, Enforcement Directorate, Income Tax Department, and our parliamentary democracy itself is undermined during this period. And now, for the last 4.5 years, we have seen on the name of Goraksha, Muslim minorities are attacked. More than 36 people are killed in this country on the name of Goraksha. And on the other side, Dalits, starting from Una in Gujarat up to Saharanpur in Uttar Pradesh, several thousands of Dalits are being attacked by them. There is no security, there is no safety for Muslim minorities, Dalits, rationalists, intellectuals and secular forces in this country. It is time, now unitedly, we should all fight together. we the communists are ready to fight along with the secular forces in spite of several differences on the economic issues and all that. Today, the main target should be overthrowing the communal Narendra Modi government. This resolution rightly points out about the electoral reforms. The electoral reforms are some small things which have been done. Indrajit Gupta Committee, which is put for electoral reforms, has proposed proportional representation. And here in this resolution, it is rightly pointed out that proportional representation should be the main reform the country needs today. Instead of giving 33% reservation for the women, 10% reservation is proposed for the upper caste poor. This was resented by many sections of the people. There was a need for a discussion. There are poor people, but the constitution very clearly says social and educational backwardness. That is the criteria for the reservation in the country. And for the economically weaker sections, certain other things like scholarships and other encouragements can be given. We are ready for a discussion, but the way they were introduced, in 2 days, forcibly, they introduced the bill only as a gimmick for electoral gains. All these should be fought back, and the so-called promises like bringing back the black money, that has not been implemented. Demonetization has further destroyed. GST also created problems, and all these type of things are to be intolerable things. That is why we are today uniting, and this unity should reflect in 2019 elections to defend the nation, to save the country. And once again, I congratulate Comrade Thirumavalavan for the initiative which he has taken, and I support the resolution. Thank you very much.